Sorry, I'm deaf, so I can't really understand what you're saying.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on one second.
Can talk. Why didn't you just say you order? Sometimes when I order something through the drive-thru, they don't understand my speech. I know what happens to hearing people. I know most of the time the order taker will ask me questions and I'll have no idea what they're saying. Everyone should do an experiment. Go to a drive-thru and order something. And then don't say anything else and see if your food is right when you pick it up at the window. If you try the experiment, let me know how it goes.
You want me to cook dinner?
Sure.
Okay. Amanda. Amanda. Do you want me to cook dinner?
Oh, I'm gonna roast you!
What's popping? Today I'm gonna be teaching you guys manners in ASO. Let's go. Thank you. Thank you. Welcome. Welcome. Excuse me. Excuse me. Please. Please. Sorry. Sorry. Before I end the video, I want to thank you all for all the support. I really appreciate it. I hope you guys learned a lot of ASO. I hope you guys are looking forward to learning more ASO. I'm out. Peace.
To make sure.
Wobble it. No, scratch your leg.
That makes a noise. That makes a noise. How? Oh, this sounds so cool. Sounds already really cool. It's really exciting.
Pros and cons of having a deaf brother. Sometimes it's hard for me to get his attention. I don't have to run all the way up to him to talk to him.
Too ugly.
deaf people can enjoy music and blind people can enjoy movies. Studies have shown that deaf people actually feel the vibrations of the music and then process it in the same part of the brain that processes hearing, and can also use technology such as this shirt, which amplifies the vibrations of the music. And blind people can enjoy movies with the help of a narrated audio description. This narration describes visual events on the screen that can't be understood from listening to the dialogue alone.
Welcome to Comments I Hate Getting About Being Deaf. Okay, the first one is, how do you talk so clearly? I know you're interested, but please think logically. Not being able to hear doesn't take away from your vocal cords. I understand it can affect it, but it doesn't stop completely. Therefore, me and a lot of other people can still talk. Question 2, if I scream into your ear really loudly, can you hear? No, it's not how that works. If someone were to like scream into my ear, it would be like super loud, yeah, but like it would be so muffled that I wouldn't understand a word. 3, if you're deaf, how do you listen to music? Why are you wearing earbuds? I have Bluetooth hearing aids, but the hearing aid itself, it glitches so much that I use earbuds. When I want to listen to music and stuff, I take the earbud and I put it on top of the microphone that is on my hearing aid, and then I put it on my ear. If I want to listen to music for the beat or rhythm, I get the big headphones and feel vibrations.
Kylie, deaf? How?
Gup.
You were born deaf?
Nah.
Whoa.
Bang.
Hey Chrissy, how do you make TikToks if you can't hear the music?
What? Totally get it. A lot of people are curious about this. There's two main ways I can do it. First, I can ask a friend for help and they can stand behind the camera and direct me the sound. Or I can watch another video and copy it and try and follow the timing. It's tough, but it works out.
Hi. Kylie, does it hurt to talk?
No.
No?
Happy.
Happy?
Huh?
Oh.
Yeah.
Bye.
What? When you brush your fingers in your hair, does that make noise? What?
Hip-hop. Pa-pa-pa-pa.
Hearing people shouldn't teach sign language. You've probably heard that before, and here's why it's true. So first off, hearing brains and deaf brains process differently. Deaf people have a tendency of viewing the world visually. They use strong picture concepts to communicate meanings and phrases. Whereas hearing people have a tendency to think very vocabulary based, very wordy. For example, if I was to say, the telephone pole is broken, the hearing person would typically say, the telephone pole broke, whereas the deaf person would set up the telephone pole and show it's broken. But honestly, taking a sign language class with a hearing teacher is better than not taking a sign language class. In a perfect world, all sign language teachers would be deaf.
Today, I'm gonna be showing you guys colors in ASL. Let's go. Red, red. Blue, blue, green, green, orange, orange, yellow, yellow, purple, purple, pink, 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 gray, 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 white, white, black, black.
Hello, 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 hello.
Remember the words you told me, love me till the day I die. Surrender my everything, cause you made me believe you're mine. Yeah, you used to call me baby, now you're calling me by name. Takes one to know one, yeah, you beat me at my own damn game.
Look me in my eyes and tell me deaf and hard of hearing people can't drive because they can't hear the surroundings. You're the dude going 80 in a 65 and blaring your tunes. You're not fucking listening to the road. Closed captions need to be everywhere. TV and the movies. Everywhere. Not only because, duh, let's accommodate people. How useful would that be for people who have English as a second language?
Hey, Rebethica, I know you took French in high school. I know that when you studied abroad in Paris, you were like, oh man, I read everything in subtitles. The captions are so distracting. Hold up, babe. This is what you can do. You see that? Hold on, let me do it again for you. Wait, I don't know. One more time, babe. I don't know. It's an idea. Chill out, guy. I got good news. All of this stuff that we can do to help. Come here, come here. Come here. It's free.
I want you to park that Big Mac truck right in this little garage.
You gave me a shoulder when I needed it. You showed me love when I wasn't feeling it. You helped me fight when I was giving in. And you made me laugh when I